Thanks. Remember this moment on the Trump campaign trail?
I know more about ISIS than the generals do, believe me.
Reminds me of the line, often wrong, but never in doubt. And it's that kind of self-assurance in the face of facts and experience that led Defense Secretary Jim Mattis's resignation. The last of the so-called axis of adults is leaving the building. And the tipping point? The president's decision to withdraw from Syria despite the unanimous advice of the military brass. In the announcement, the president falsely stated that, quote, we have defeated ISIS in Syria. That's certainly not what this CNN footage from Syria taken earlier this week shows. It's not what our allies or our generals are seeing on the ground. Despite the strong progress we've made, this fight isn't over. As one senior administration official told Jake Tapper, quote, the president's decision by tweet will recklessly put American and allied lives in danger around the world, take the pressure off ISIS, allowing them to reconstitute, and hand a strategic victory to our Syrian, Iranian, and Russian adversaries. It's a mistake of colossal proportions, and the president fails to see how it will endanger our country. A bipartisan group of six senators agreed, firing off a letter urging the president to reconsider. Instead, the president seems to have doubled down, again choosing to please Vladimir Putin over the Pentagon by mulling an over 50% drawdown of U.S. troops in Afghanistan. Look, Trump's isolationist impulses overturn a half century of Republican internationalism, dating back to Eisenhower and exemplified by Reagan and Bush 41. And this vote of no confidence from Mattis represents a stark departure from our best traditions, because such high-profile breaks with presidents over policy differences are very rare. Got to go back to Woodrow Wilson when Secretary of State Williams Jennings Bryan resigned over disagreements about getting into World War I. Just wasn't a good fit between the isolationist populist and the progressive president. Fast forward to Harry Truman and the so-called Revolt of the Admirals, a rare public outcry from senior military men over Truman's attempt to slash defense budgets and emphasize nukes over the Navy. As the Vietnam War raged, its architect, Defense Secretary Robert McNamara, handed in his resignation to President Johnson once he realized there was no way to escalate out of the quagmire. Jimmy Carter's Secretary of State, Cyrus Vance, resigned over the president's decision to try a military rescue for the U.S. hostages in Iran. Operation Eagle Claw failed. Eight service members died. And Carter eventually blamed his 1980 election loss on it. So Vance's resignation looked not just principled, but prescient. And that's about it. It's been nearly 40 years since we've seen a resignation by a major cabinet figure over a policy difference with the president. And Mattis didn't simply resign over a tactical plan. His resignation was over a worldview, calling out Trump's alienation of our allies and embrace of our adversaries. All this should remind you that these are strange days. Now, Mattis joins this long list of administration officials who've either run for the exits or been pushed out the door, demonstrating the radius of chaos emanating from this Oval Office. And that's your reality check.